Welcome to part 3 of my lecture on Dover, Matthew Arnold's famous poem, Dover Beach. So as I had told you in the earlier video, the poet is standing on the side of Dover and he's looking at the calm, tranquil bay, calm, tranquil sea in front of him. And looking at the sea, he can see the shining cliffs of the white shining cliffs of Dover, right? What is the meaning of cliff? The rock peaks, right? The rock peaks in the sea. Now, looking at the peaks, the poet says, the poet is there at the Dover beach with his beloved. So, the poet calls the beloved outside, asks her to come out and says, come to the window. Come outside, look at the sea, look at the night air. The night air is sweet and pleasant. Only from the long line of spray where the sea meets the moon blanched land. Look at the beautiful comparison. It is a beautiful moonlit night. It is a full moon. It is a beautiful moonlit night. And so at that place where the sea meets the land, listen, you hear the grating roar of pebbles which the waves draw back and fling at the return up the high strand. So the waves are coming and hitting the pebbles on the beach. They begin and cease. The waves come and go back. The waves come and go back. And as the poet is looking at this beautiful scenery and is asking his beloved to feel the scene, to hear the sounds of the scene, suddenly the poet becomes very sad. The eternal, with tremulous cadence, these waves bring the eternal note of sadness in. Suddenly the poet becomes very sad. As he is looking at the waves coming and going, the waves of the sea are coming to the beach of Dover. They are, as they hit the pebbles and go back, as they touch the pebbles and go back, the poet is looking at this coming and going, and suddenly he becomes very sad. He feels sad suddenly. Why does the poet feel sad? Look at the second stanza. The poet says in the second stanza, Sophocles long ago heard it on the Aegean, and it brought into his mind the turbid ebb and flow of human misery. So he refers to another Greek poet and dramatist, Sophocles. Who is Sophocles? Sophocles is a great Greek poet and dramatist. The poet is reminded of Sophocles because Sophocles also, once upon a time, long, long ago, was standing at the Aegean Sea, the name of a sea in Europe. If you look at it, you can see it there. He was looking at the sea, and as he was looking at the waves coming and going, he also felt a note of sadness. So just like Sophocles, the poet Arnold also feels a note of sadness suddenly. We find also in the sound a thought, hearing it by this distant northern sea. So the poet says, just as Sophocles had heard, felt sad at this coming and going of the waves and had felt about the human misery, so also I, as I am standing here at the Dover beach and as I am looking at the waves, I also feel suddenly very sad. Why does the poet feel sad? He explains in stanza 3. He says, he feels sad because he feels that the sea of faith of the human beings in religion, in God, is receding, is becoming small and small. Now, why is the sea of faith becoming small? Now, look at the genius of the poet. He was talking about the beauty of the sea, and from the beauty of the sea, he goes into the depths of human misery. He feels, as he looks at the sea, the poet feels that the sea of faith is becoming less and less. Now, why does the poet make this reference? Now, for this, you have to go back to the time of the poem, the publishing of the poem. As I had told you, Matthew Arnold belongs to the Victorian era, right? Victorian era. The poem was written in, the poem was first published in 1867. 1867 is the later part of the 19th century. Now, what was happening in the 19th century? 19th century was an age of many scientific discoveries. I'll stop here, and in my next part, the part 4 of the video, we will discuss the 19th century and its chief characteristics and the sea of faith becoming small. Thank you.